Ceasefire, go back to your seat, go back to your seat.
His trek on Uganda's political and leadership tarmac roads has not been smooth.
I've instructed my lawyers to take government Nagrik to court.
He has encountered speed bumps called saboteurs.
You would allow General Tafide to tell us why either himself or his name is involved in grabbing of public land.
Traffic lights called political opponents.
Is this impunity of the highest order?
What you said, repeat it outside this house.
And the obstacles called disagreements.
So come and tell us how you acquired government land. You let the papers here.
But with a gear lever called patience, a steering wheel called determination, and a braking system called consensus, he continues to make it in his career.
When two people are working together, and if when they don't disagree, it means one of them is thinking. When two people are working together on the same program and disagree, that's healthy. When they don't disagree, then there is something wrong. If disagreement is not the problem, it's the inability to overcome the contradiction that is the problem.
Disagreements have not only been experienced at parliamentary level, but also partly in his own political party, the National Resistance Movement. His relationship with former party secretary general Amama Mbabazi is clear testimony to this.
But I sometimes disagree with his methods. Sometimes I disagree with his strategy. You know, sometimes we don't agree, but we are not enemies. We disagree. You know? And I proved him wrong. Say the way you are running the NRM is not exactly the way it should be done. You know, and now you can see subsequently what is happening.
Whereas he clarifies that he holds nothing personal against Mbabazi, he blames the recent loss of NRM in Buganda sub-region on the former Prime Minister. Otafire now wants him to come and clear what he describes as a mess that he created within the party.
Because you could see it was coming, that the way we are handling the central region and other areas, we are going to end up in this problem. You know, in Uganda, there are errors we made, which have resulted in what has happened. And I used to warn Mbabas about this possibility.
In fact, he blames the rise of National Unity Platform on errors made in the National Resistance Movement. However, this to him is not a threat to the ruling party.
It's painful that Buganda, that at this epoch, Buganda, which used to have over one third of members in the NRM caucus, now instead of 100, they have less than 30. And it's the NRM caucus that determines the direction of the country.
Whereas he confirms enjoying music by NUP President Robert Kyagulanyi, he notes that the youthful politician does not understand the trap that he got himself into.
Very good composer, very good music, he's my friend. But he knows much about music and very little about management of society.
We don't like that man Museveni. Museveni lives forever. After Museveni has gone, what next? Ask him.
According to Otafire, Bobi Wine, as he's also known, does not understand the hidden agenda by the people he describes as neo-colonialists.
Innocent Kyagulanyi does not understand the imperial machinations, you know, the economic relation, the parasitic relationship between Africa and metropolitan Europe. He does not understand that relationship. That for Europe to develop, Africa must underdevelop. There is that parasitic relationship. Does he understand it?
As opposed to promoting the Western agenda, Otafide prefers fronting African unity, a reason he has reservations about Buganda's demand for federalism.
They forget that we are Africans, we are East Africans, and we are Ugandans. They start with Uganda. But it is their democratic and God-given right to talk about themselves. That's what I want to hear. And there is no way I can persuade them to abandon that cause unless I listen to what they are saying. And then they listen to what I'm saying. You know, I want that opportunity to talk to them and say, these views of you, as wonderful as they are wrong.
It is this similar spirit of unity that he is advancing in the East African region. As Uganda's minister for East African community, whereas there are some reservations, he insists East African nations need each other for a common good.
Once you are in a federation, you can plan for production, and each partner state produces what it produces at comparative economic advantage. But right now we are all competing, milk, eggs, everybody. Like now Kenya says, Kenyans must eat expensive eggs because it must protect its own producers to the detriment of Kenyans. There are cheap eggs in Uganda, but Kenya can't buy them. And Kenya forces Kenyan citizens to eat expensive eggs when there are cheaper eggs in Uganda. But if we had the federation, that would not obtain.
General Kahinda Otafire, who was voted out of parliament in 2016, was voted back to the House in the January 2021 polls. But what does he bring on table this time?
Fighting for my constituency without the other constituencies benefiting does not help my constituency. Because if you build a road in my constituency and it doesn't reach anywhere, it doesn't go anywhere else, what does my constituency gain? You can't fly power to my constituency without passing it through other areas.
The 70-year-old has been this successful because of his ability to distinguish between family and work. With a wife and children, the retired Major General in the Ugandan Army spends his free time reading and monitoring activities in his farm. To this effect, he has a word for youth.
What they know, we know. What we know, they don't. We also wanted quick words. We didn't get it.
Henry Okurut, UBC.